I am concerned like anybody else, a sudden spike in these cases means that the virus had not gone anywhere outside the state. It's only now that we tested the BSF Jawans, and then through their contacts and their subsequent testing, these cases from 0 to 40 have come about. So, of course, I'm concerned. I'm also concerned that this virus does not spread into the civilian population, because right now it's under a confinement. But then if these Jawans have come into contact with the villagers or with people in their day-to-day life, they, or the doctors who then have subsequently passed it on, then this is a big concern. And I'm extremely worried like anybody else that this if there is more testing, more could be found out. So yes, we're all keeping our fingers crossed. But the bigger point here is that what are we doing? Rather, we are just hiding away from the virus. Are we doing something to take on the virus? Are we doing something which will help our people understand that more needs to be done? So that's where my bigger concern is.
Whatever reports we are getting from the ground, even though, as you rightly mentioned, the outbreak is was inside the BSF campus, but definitely, the BSF paramilitary does have contact with the civilians. So there is no room for confidence. Are you satisfied with the piece of contact tracing that has been initiated, especially in Dhalai district?
It's not only Dhalai district, it's all over Tripura. Because you've had cases in Gomati, you've had these people in Gandachara. These are areas which are slightly remote. Ambassa, of course, being the epicenter right now. But my point is, I don't want to indulge in saying that the government is doing a bad job. The government is obviously trying. But the fact is that, was the government prepared? I believe that the government was prepared only to a certain degree, not only in Tripura, but across the country. And the opposition had nothing positive to even offer to the government. So I believe that the lack of preparedness, the lack of response is a collective fault of both the opposition, which is indulging in negative propaganda, and the government, which is looking at event management. So I think on both sides, both the opposition and the government needs to buck up. And this is a big sign to all the people of this country not to depend only on politicians. Democracy does not only depend on one pillar of society. There are different pillars of society, whether it is judiciary, whether it is media, whether it's civil society itself. So I think it's time we stepped up ourselves. Certain states are doing a better job than the other. In my state, I believe that the government needs to engage more with the people. The helplines need to be picked up by people when people call up who are desperate. The government needs to be more proactive. The government cannot depend on one individual to function. In Assam, it is Hemanta Biswa Sarma who is the face which is fighting the COVID. My question is, where are the other people who have been elected? Why aren't they there themselves in the constituencies, in the districts? The same way in Tripura, it cannot be one or two individuals who are supposed to be outsourced the fight against COVID. It has to be everyone, including the people in the opposition, the people in the government, the MLAs, the DMs, the judiciary, the media, everyone. And they cannot be towing a propagandist line.
So when you say that we cannot just depend on the politicians or the government, is this not where also somebody like you step in Tripura, possibly?
Well, my organization, Tripura, has probably done the most amount of work, not just in Tripura, but even outside Tripura. Whether it is helping our students or migrant workers in Guwahati, whether it was in Hyderabad, whether it was in Bangalore, Chennai, Kerala, Maharashtra, we have been helping. In Tripura itself, we have helped over 9,000 families. This is big numbers. And we have not taken donation from any political parties or any religious organization. These are self-funded. And when we started with our own money. Jab tak log paisa apne pocket se nikal kar logo ko nahi denge. Wo social media mein, if you keep on giving somebody 2 kilos of rice and taking a photograph, and then doing a photo op, what comes out of it? And let me tell you one more thing. Lot of people go and give 5 kilos of rice, dal, with the picture of the leader or a flag of the political party. Those people, unko to lena padega because unko dal chawal chahiye. Lekin, they also have self-respect. Kyunki they don't have rice and food ration right now. They are taking it. But to do this and then to put it up in Facebook and Instagram and say we have helped 5 people. What are we doing? This is not the time for us to be Congress, BJP, CPM, AGP, any party. This is the time for us to help each other irrespective of our political and religious affiliation. So, yes, my organization has done it and we have done a very good job. And now we have also announced a further fund where whoever is stranded outside Tripura and wants to come back, we will also contribute in cash to help them to come back. Of course, they will have to contribute something on their own, but we are doing it from our own pockets. These are very important things.
Now also, you know, every time in most of the states, of course, thankfully it's less now as they with the central country, but every time it becomes the opposition versus the government thing in any crisis, but this crisis is totally different. But, you know, as somebody who is very involved in the state, do you see the government also taking suggestions, be it from the opposition, be it from someone like you, be it from some social organizations, is the government also open to suggestions that is that the case, or there is a miscommunication here too? What do you feel personally?
No, the Chief Minister did call for an all-party meet. I am personally speaking to the Chief Minister. So, the government is listening. But the problem is, listening is one part of the job. Implementation of what we are saying. Implementation of what the Chief Minister himself is telling us on Twitter is not happening to the optimum on the ground. I'll give you an example, the helplines. I call up the helplines, it took me 5 days to get through to the helpline. So the helplines are not responsive. People get desperate. A lot of people who are outside have lost their jobs. These are not blue collared workers. Ye log restaurant mein kaam karte hain, security guards hain. मॉल्स में सिक्योरिटी का काम करते हैं. दे वॉन्ट टू कम बैक, उनको वापस आना है. जब वो फोन हेल्पलाइन में लगाते और फोन का रिस्पॉन्स नहीं होता, दे गेट पैनिकी. लैंडलॉर्ड्स बोलते कि वापस चले जाओ, क्योंकि नॉर्थ ईस्ट से आपको सरकार आपको ला रही है. अब हेमंत बिस्व शर्मा आपको ला रहा है, कॉन्राड सांगमा ला रहा है, त्रिपुरा नहीं ला रहा है, पेमा खांडू ला रहा है. तो नाउ उनको उनको लगता है कि नॉर्थ ईस्ट ला रहा है. नॉर्थ ईस्ट में 8 different states है. त्रिपुरा हैज टू टेक स्टेप्स. Tripura has to respond. And the only way you can respond to people outside is by actually responding to the helpline. So, government is listening, but the work on the ground has to improve a lot more.
Absolutely. But do you think, as you also mentioned earlier, as far as COVID precautions concerns, Assam, for instance, you have to give it to Assam. Well, they have prepared well, far ahead.
Even no, you can't give it to Assam. I'm sorry. You have to only give it to Hemant Biswa Sarma and maybe Piyush.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So you can't give it to Assam. You have to give it to Piyush and Hemant Biswa Sarma. There are 124 other MLAs in Assam. Most of them, some are of course working, most of them are just keeping quiet.
Absolutely. That has been the case. It's been a one-man show. But again, Tripura, now we have, okay, it may be the BFF, Parametry, but we have 42 cases, 40 active cases, but we still are looking for a completely, you know, COVID, dedicated COVID hospitals or GB per hospital. Shouldn't that have been converted into,
I think that GB should not have been converted.
COVID hospital?
I think GB is the biggest hospital in Agartala and it should not have been converted. Maybe another hospital should have been converted because there are other patients who have cancer, who have tuberculosis, who have other heart ailments. And if GB becomes a COVID hospital and they have to shut it down, where do other patients who have other diseases come to? So I think my suggestion is that there should be other hospital in Agartala itself, in the periphery, which should be converted into a COVID hospital, and GB should still be a hospital for other patients with other illnesses to come to. That's my view at least. Because if GB shuts down, like the Jaslok Hospital in Bombay or other hospitals, because there are the doctors have got corona and the entire place has become a hotspot, then where do people go to? You have to build up your infrastructure beyond your existing main hospital. So the government needs to do something like that.
Absolutely. My last question, sir, what would you like to say to the government on the way ahead? Anything that you want to suggest?
Act, test, and listen. But after listening, act again. And please, my only urge is spend money. The people of Tripura need to be brought back. The people in the villages need rice. Everybody is stepping up for that. But right now, spend. Your money will come back. But if you don't have lives to defend, if your public, your people get frustrated, you will have a problem in your hands. And I also have a message to the opposition. In the Communist Party, in the Congress Party, we have over 50 to 60 ex-MLAs who get a good amount of pension. Rather than complaining, why don't you put 50% of your pension and ensure that people get help? Right now, you are only playing politics. You are not helping. Put the money where the problem is. Don't make long speeches. We are putting our own resources. We are going and helping. We are doing our best. It's time for you all leaders who pretend to be leaders to put the money where your mouth is.
Thank you. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.